Do you know this plant? This is Cicuta virosa from the family Apiaceae, commonly known as myrkkykeiso in Finnish and cowbane or northern water hemlock in English. It is native to the northern hemisphere but is more common in Eurasia than in North America. Thankfully, there have been only a few mentions of medicinal use in the past, probably because the entire plant is very, very toxic, with the root containing the highest concentrations. It should not be touched with bare hands, and a single raw root is enough to kill an adult. Broken roots have been known to poison nearby water areas to the extent that even drinking the water can cause symptoms. Exercise extreme caution if you suspect you are dealing with Cicuta virosa. It is perennial and blooms from July to August. It prefers areas in shallows or near water like shorelines, river deltas, along small streams or the edges of ponds. Its white flowers grow in umbels at the top of the plant, similar to other Apiaceae, but the shape of its leaves is usually the first warning. They are divided into leaflets either once or twice. Individual leaflets are usually 0.5 to 1 cm wide and serrated along the edge. To confirm the identification, one can very carefully dig up the root and split it in half to find it hollow and split into several small compartments. The leaves smell like dill or parsley, and the split root has a strong smell similar to raw celery and is said to taste deceptively sweet. Gloves, clothes that cover skin, and waterproof boots are strongly recommended, and under no circumstances should any part of the plant be left lying around. If possible, all fragments should be put in a plastic bag and burned, as the plant can spread from the smallest root fragments, and any bits left lying around can accidentally be eaten by pets or children. If the plant has been taken apart in or near the water, going into or using the water should be avoided for at least a few hours, if not overnight. It can be confused with other Apiaceae, such as Heracleums, Icopodium podagraria, Anthriscus sylvestris, or Angelica archangelica, and those gathering wild herbs for cooking have been known to confuse it with wild carrot, wild celery, or parsley. However, most of these have leaves that are either narrower and feathery, or noticeably wider, and can be found in areas without immediate access to water. Would you confuse it with anything else? Warn me in the comments.